Greetings, AC family. Welcome to another episode of the AntsCanada Ant Channel. Here on the AC Channel, we watch ants feeding, we watch them moving into new homes, we watch them grow, and we also share useful tips on how to care for ant colonies. However, from time to time, we are graced with the opportunity to hear from people who are actual experts on ants. People who dedicate their lives to studying them. These are the ant gurus of the myrmecological world. With nuptial flight season officially starting in the Northern Hemisphere, today we sit down with Dr. Brian Fisher, creator of antweb.org, from the California Academy of Sciences, who will share with us how you, yes you, can actually be a contributor to scientific ant research. You may even be keeping a brand new undiscovered ant species without even knowing it. We also have an update on our queen trapjaw ant that you may have seen in a previous video. Did she survive? It's a shocker. You won't want to miss all this and more ahead, so keep watching until the end. AC family, find out why you out there watching are important to myrmecology, the study of ants, as we sit and learn from an ant master in this week's episode of the AntsCanada Ant Channel. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Welcome to the AC family. Enjoy. During a recent trip to San Francisco, California, I was able to visit the California Academy of Sciences to visit one of the most famous ant scientists. They're called myrmecologists in the entire world. Dr. Brian Fisher was one of my greatest idols for years, ever since I started seriously keeping ants. So naturally, I fanboyed. Dr. Fisher was the creator of antweb.org, the world's largest online database of images, specimen records, and natural history information on ants. It is community-driven and open to contribution from anyone with specimen records, natural history comments, or images. As an ant keeper and ant lover like all of you, I had so much to ask him on behalf of us, the AC family. Hello, Dr. Fisher. Thank you for taking the time to join us today. Please kindly introduce yourself to the AC family.
Hello, I'm Brian Fisher, and people call me the Ant Explorer or the Species Explorer.
Please describe what you do in your career in studying ants.
I'm here at a museum. It's one of the largest museums in the world, and it's called the California Academy of Sciences. At this museum, we have a research side. That's where I work, that's where I hide, that's in the basement. We have one of the largest collections of ants in the world. And then we have a public face. That's the public museum where you can go and look at the aquarium, look at the rainforest, go to the planetarium. But I rarely get up there because when I walk in, I can't get away from the basement.
You are the founder of antweb.org, the biggest ant species database in the world. How did that start?
When I first went to the tropics, it was like 30 years ago, I went to Panama, and it was that trip where I fell in love with ants. And they were everywhere, right? I went down to study plants, but I saw these ants and I was like, I gotta know about these ants. But I couldn't find out any information. There wasn't like a field guide to the ants. There were field guides to birds everywhere, but not for ants. And I said, wait a minute, how can this be that we have this incredible diversity and we know nothing about it? Then I couldn't find anybody to tell me anything. So I decided at that point I wanted to study ants. And I wanted to, in a sense, know the name of every ant in the world. And not just its name, what it looked like, where it lived, whether or not it's endangered. And I realized later it'd be even better if we could actually use that information to show that humans, our survival, is somehow linked to that. Like, is it true that the ants are the glue that holds forests together? Is it true that we actually need ants? Well, ants are invisible to most people. And my goal with AntWeb was to make them visible. In a sense, put a face on it. Not just a name, you know. At that time, we didn't even know the name of all the ants in the world. But let's do more than that. Let's put a face on that. So I wanted to create that field guide. I wanted to create that tool, in a sense, to be able to go anywhere in the world and know what's there and know what it looked like.
Tell us about how you take these photos of ants for AntWeb.
Now, we've imaged, so far, 41,000 specimens. Not just a typical click image, but each of those images is a composite. We take images through the plane of focus, and we make a composite image, taking the parts in focus from each image, making a mosaic of a single image where it's all in focus. That's the image on AntWeb. It's 70 to 100 images in a mosaic. And we take a profile, a headshot, a dorsal view, and a label. That's the 41,000 specimens. We've gotten about 75% of all ant types imaged. And each summer, we're going out again to raise funds. And if you ever want to help us do that, that'd be great. We want to finish this. We want to actually finish imaging every species, because we need every species so that we can generate on the fly the ants of your backyard, the ants of Ghana, the ants of Canada. We can image, for those images, we can create these field guides.
How does one discover a new species of ant?
So, how do you know you have a new species of ant, right? So you go out in your backyard, you find this ant and go, is it new? Is it a new species? Well, it's the same thing I do every trip I take. So we work, right now we're focused on Madagascar, trying to describe all the species. So we do it this way. We go out into a new forest, we hike, we get there, we do our traps, we come back, and then we sort all those specimens that we collected to what we call morpho species. We look at and see, this one looks different than that one, that one's different than that one. After they're sorted, we mount them up, we pin them, and label them with all their data, and then we compare each of those morpho species to everything we already know. Before AntWeb, that meant you would have to take your collection, travel to Europe, and go to each museum and compare your specimens to the type specimens. That's what every ant taxonomist or every ecologist did before AntWeb. Now with AntWeb, we kind of like democratized that process. So that means you go and compare all your specimens to the images. And using keys and using images, you can get pretty close to figure out the identity of that specimen.
Why is classification of ant species important?
Classification is important because once you know the name, you've opened up all the information about that specimen, about that species, about the potential biology. Remember what I said, I wanted to know every name, what it looked like, but also its distribution, whether or not it's endangered, whether or not we could actually use that information. And this is where it gets problematic. But this is also problems or opportunities, and this is your opportunity to make a contribution. Now, we've only discovered about 20% of all insects on Earth. We've discovered maybe 50% of all ants, right? What did I say? Yes, we only have described 50% of all ant species on Earth. That means, more than likely, there's something in your own backyard that's a new species.
Why must we know about every single ant? How does that help?
Each ant represents kind of its own set of evolved problem-solving solutions to that environmental story. So each one has potential, a unique story that is important for that whole ecosystem. You see, we don't really understand what the complexity and uncertainty of nature. So we're just beginning. But each story is part of that puzzle that we should actually take the time to understand. And by knowing its name, we can start adding information about what that species does, who it's related to, because relationship is really an important part of the story. Where did it evolve from? You know, ants evolved from wasps and bees. They're specialized wasps. But also within ants, it's good to know who this relationship is about. You know, like, is it a dracal ant? Well, if it's a dracal ant, then maybe we know something about its life history and that it eats and drinks the blood of its own babies, for example. So that's important. But above all, I think it's important because it represents each species, a unique part of the story.
What if any of our AC family members watching are just kids or have no scientific background? How can we help in ant research?
If you start collecting and you also record the data, you instantly become a contributor to science. As exploration can be done by anybody. All it takes is persistence and patience. Now, if you have a live colony, you're probably the first person to actually sit and watch it in those circumstances. You know, it's biology. It's alive, it's natural history, and nobody's probably taken the time to observe those interactions, even the seasonality. When does it produce babies? When does it produce larvae? What does it feed the larvae? When does it produce new queens and males? All that interesting biology can be recorded and put into information online that other people can access. You can use iNaturalist, you can use AntWeb, you can use any other the other interesting blogs, but don't hide the information. If you share it, that's when you become a scientist. That's when you become a contributor.
what about those of us who don't keep ants? What are some of the ways in which a non-ant keeper can contribute to ant research?
How can you help? Well, one, I think the most important is to convince others to see ants. Like I said, for most people, ants are invisible. If you have those eyes, you start seeing ants, I think you should share that with others. And I think, as you probably realized, the most important thing is not simply understanding the importance of ants. It's that understanding the environment is the best path through our enlightenment of our society. Because if we don't figure out that ants are important, we'll never figure out, in a sense, that we are impacting the environment. And that is important. Now, as I said, we understand very little about the environment, maybe only 20% of the species. And therefore, we don't have like a Dow Jones index to the environment. We don't have any way to look at it holistically. But most importantly, we need to see those ants. And you all see it, and that's important. But if you want to help further, you can get those ants that you find, and if you identify something new and exciting, get it to a museum, get it to a taxonomist. And if you want to help us finish imaging all the ants of the world, we need your help. That's AntWeb. Help AntWeb. You can contact antweb.org, and we have mechanisms to donate money to the California Academy of Sciences AntWeb Project, and there we'll make sure we'll dedicate your money to imaging the next species.
What is your favorite species of ant?
My favorite ant are the Dracula ants. Now, I just still can't believe it that there are ants that have to scratch their own babies until they bleed, and that even the queen has to drink the blood of their own babies. So for me, every time I find a Dracula ant, that's a good day.
Thanks so much, Dr. Brian, for sitting with the AC family today. We've learned so much.
It's been a great pleasure to meet the Ants Canada folks, and I hope the ants stay with you forever.
So there you have it. Isn't that beautiful, guys? All of you out there watching are valuable to myrmecology, the study of ants. Whether you're an ant keeper, or someone who likes to look at ants, or even a viewer on this channel, there are so many ways in which you can help contribute to the study of these little six-legged miracles. Oh yeah, and I also made sure to make a donation of $500 on behalf of us, the AC family, for the AntWeb project. High five, AC family! We've all contributed to myrmecological research. For those of you keeping ants now, have a look at antweb.org. You can search your location and look up the ants in your region, and if the ant you have does not match any of the ants listed in your area, send a dead ant specimen in some laboratory-grade alcohol over to Dr. Brian Fisher. I'll put information in the description. And maybe, just maybe, you will have discovered a brand new ant species. And hey, if you do, and you have the privilege of naming this newly discovered species from your backyard, please add AntsCanadensis somewhere in the species name. Huh? All right, so now, an update on our beautiful trap jaw queen ant that we caught a few months back. We've all been waiting to see if she would lay eggs. After caring for her and feeding her for months, she has sadly passed away. She likely was not fertilized, which happens in queen ant collecting. However, we do have some great news next week. Thanks for watching another episode of the Ants Canada Ant Channel. Did you guys enjoy chatting with Dr. Fisher? For those of you inner colony members, Dr. Fisher even took us into the vault, one of the largest collections of ant specimens in the entire world. Talk about VIP once-in-a-lifetime access. To walk with Brian into the vault, click this hidden video here, inner colony, to see what this vault looks like. And now for the AC question of the week. Last week we asked, what is the name of the groupings of nerves controlling movement in insects? Congratulations to Neptune, who correctly answered ganglia. Congratulations, Neptune, you just won a free ant t-shirt from our shop. For this week's AC question of the week, we ask, why are Dracula ants called Dracula ants? Leave your answer in the comments section and you could win some free test tubes from our shop. Perfect for housing your newly caught queen ants to start your own ant colonies. Right on time for nuptial flight season happening right now in North America, Europe, and Northern Asia. Hope you guys can subscribe and be sure to leave a comment. Let me know what you guys think of scientist chat videos like this. And starting now, I'm gonna start pinning my favorite random comments in each video. See you guys next week, AC family. So much exciting ant stuff ahead for you guys. Why? Well, let Brian tell you.
It's Ant Love Forever.
Please subscribe to the channel. We release a video every single week about ants. It's Ant Love Forever.